This conference will now be recorded.
Hello guys, welcome back. So now again I'm going to explain this document posting itself. In previous session, what I have done, guys, I've shown you guys how to post a transactions and by using transaction code F-02. But again, in F-02, what is happening? You have to give the posting key. You have to give a posting key in the sense like 40, 50, and all. Now again, I told you, like, there might be a question in your mind that do we need to give posting key every time, because multiple posting keys are there? How come it possible to remember all the posting key, right? Which posting key is going to be used when is very difficult to remember, right? So again, do we have any other options to post the transactions? So yes guys, we do have options to post the transactions where you are not going to give the posting key manually. You need to select debit and credit, this one options only. System is going to determine the posting key automatically. Okay, system is going to determine the posting key automatically. So what is that transaction guide? I'll show you. Now that transaction code is, again, we are going to post normal JV itself. I'll show you here in the previous transaction. This is what the documents we have posted. Now instead of 500, now I'm going to make it a different 600, so that the amounts will be identical, right? Earlier 500, this time 600. So now here, you just do one thing. Use transaction code FP50. With the help of FP50, also we are going to post JV. Now look at here, guys, how simple a screen this is, because on a single screen itself, I'm going to give each and everything. Earlier, like, we used to, first screen was appearing where the header details were there, right? Then after that, bottom one line item was there where, like, you used to give your posting key and GL account. Again, on next screen, again, line item details itself were appearing. Line item details itself were appearing, right? And again, next screen, line item details were appearing. So that is a bit confusing because two, three screens were appearing. Now here, the same JV can be posted by using transaction code FB50. Okay, and here, SAP has simplified all those things. Did not to switch to multiple, screens. So this is quite simple. If you talk about me, like, which for testing and all normal JV, if let's suppose like if I have to perform any testing by posting a normal JV and all, I always use FB50, and most of the people are now using FB50 itself. So it does, give your date here, document date, posting date, reference, header text, everything is there. Document type, there might be chances that this document type is not appearing for you guys. In that case, you can click on edit options, and you can here, earlier, for why it is not appearing, because document type hidden options will be there for you guys. So what you need to do, you can select any of the entry with short name or display with short name. Document will be document type ready for input means you can change the document type. Okay, earlier, like just now, the document type can be changed. If you are going to make it display with short name and save it, then what is happening, guys? Document type only will be displayed, but you won't be able to change it. Now look at here. Okay, there is no, so I think, let me log off. I'll have to log in once again. So because a different company code was appearing, so I don't know whether that company code I have really configured in this server, but our company code is different, right? So now once again, use FB50 transaction code, and here TM10. It means I'm going to change the company code. Give your date, okay, reference and header text. If you want to give anything, you can give it, or else you can leave it also. Additional details, can be given, guys. Here even we are having like the way we are going to use, text field by giving narrations and all. Likewise, this can be used, let's suppose, reference field. If you are going to post any non-PO invoices, then in reference field, you can give the invoice number, right? Multiple users are there, that you guys will come to know in upcoming sessions. One by one itself, you are going to understand each and everything. And slowly, we'll proceed further, right? So that you'll be having perfect understanding. Now, so this document date, everything is given. Company code is already appearing. Document type is already appearing, right? Give your GL account, let's suppose 4000. This is our debit GL, right? rent account. So here, now look at here, you are having options to select debit and credit. Now I'm going to select debit. How much? So 600. How much amount? 600 amount, right? And then we are having next GL bank here, that is credit. Okay, you can select here from this drop down credit, and again how much? 600. Press enter. So now system is saying that look at here, business area is a required entry, right? As I told you, we have seen even in F-02 also business area was required entry. So again you have to give the business area and press enter. So for second line item also it is required entry, so here also you have to give the business area. Then now look at here, there is no error. Okay, so how to control this, that also I'll show you guys how the fields are getting controlled. I'll show you practically, but one by one. Let me explain some more things here before that. So here what is happening now, if you want to simulate, look at here, here itself shortcut key is there, you can click on simulate and look at here, this is the accounting entry, right? How simple it is, guys. In a single screen itself everything is there. So from next time onwards, whenever you have to do the practice, better to use this FB50 itself. Okay, now if you are going to, I'll just do one thing here. If you are going to post this transaction, this transaction means this document, system will generate a document number, right? The question is which document number is going to be generated. So I'll show you before posting this, I have to explain that one also. Or else if I post this transaction, then once again I have to post it to explain that logic. So I'll explain here itself. Okay, now use transaction code. So first of all, how the document numbers are getting generated? If you are going to post a transaction, the question is how the document number is getting generated. Okay, so there is a logic. There is a logic. Try to understand this logic, guys. This is how, like, as a fresher, if you are going to try somewhere, let's suppose. So even in fresher level also, like, people will ask questions, right? Our questions means what kind of questions will be there, guys? In that also, multiple logical questions itself will be there, right? Say for example, if you post a transaction, system is going to generate a document number or transaction number. So how this, where it is coming from, how system is going to trigger this document number, right? So most of the people will say that we have created a number range, right? We have created a number range, we have given a number range, let's suppose 1000 to 1999. So from there system is going to trigger. But the question is how system is going to reach till here. There will be some sources, right? So of course I'll show you. See, whichever transactions are getting posted, guys, those transactions are getting posted against a particular document type. That already I have shown you guys, this transaction is going to be posted against a particular document type. What was the document type, guys? SA document type. So the moment I click on save button, the moment I click on save button, in the sense post button, then what is happening in background, immediately system is going to check against which document type this transaction got posted. System found SA document type. SA document type, right? Now system is going to check OBA7 transaction in background and SA document type against SA document type. What is the number range? Number range code, that is 01. And click on number range information and give your company code TM00 against this 01 code. What range we have given? 1000 to 1999, right? And then after, look at here, right side you are having number range status. So under number range status, what number is updated, guys? 1000, because previously F-02, the same JV, in the sense similar JV, we have posted by using transaction code F-02. There also the document type SA itself was appearing, right? Because FB50 is what, guys? Alternative of F-02, isn't it? So now here, what is happening, guys? So one document number is already got generated, that is document number 1000. Document number 1000 got generated. Now this time what is happening, guys? So system will check NR status. NR status already updated with number 1000. So what is the next number, guys? 1000 plus 1. So the next number which is getting generated is 1001. If I save it, control S. Look at here, document number 1001 was posted, right? How document number 1001 got created? Why not 1002? Why not 1005? Why not 3000? Why not 4000? Right? So of course there is a logic. First of all, this document number is going to be generated from the range which we have given. So there, the range itself is 1000 to 1999. Then how come it possible that it is going beyond our range? It will never go beyond your range, right? But again, the question is, how come it possible to generate the document number in a sequence wise? So of course, sequence wise is possible because there is a logic behind that. Whatever transaction, I'll repeat it once again, guys, so that you'll be having perfect understanding. So try to explain it whenever you have to explain, guys, in which way you are going to explain that whatever transactions are getting posted, those transactions are getting posted against a particular document type. Say, for example, if normal JV we are going to post. So if you post a normal JV, in that case, what is happening? That is going to be posted against a document type SA. So first of all, at the time of posting of transaction, system is going to trigger the document type. Okay. From document type, system is going to trigger the number range code which is assigned against that document type, and against that code, whatever range we have given is going to be triggered by system. Whatever range we have given is going to be against this code, whatever range is given, that is going to be triggered by system, right? And then system is going to check NR status. In NR status, whatever number, whatever the latest document got posted, that number is going to be saved here, right? So what is the next number, guys? So always the current number which is updated here plus one. So next time what will happen, guys? Next time if I'm going to post the transactions, the next time the document number should be 1002. Why? Because 1001 got already generated. But the question is, why it is not updated here? So it is not updated because the screen I have opened before the posting. Posting I have done just now, screen was opened before. So if you click on back button, then what is happening, guys? And if you go inside once again, then screen is getting refreshed. So look at here now, 1001 got updated already, and it happens with lightning speed. Okay, there, most of you are freshers, like you are doing this practice first time. I know that multiple questions will be there in your mind, but since it is a video tutorial, so it's not possible to ask, because that you can ask in live environment itself if you're going to attend any online classes and all anyway. So anyway, but still I'll try, because in my life, batches also people are going to ask such kind of questions. So now here, let's suppose if you think that, okay, say for example, 20 people or 30 people are posting a transactions at a time, or 100 people are posting a transactions at a time. So what will happen in that case? How system is going to update the recent number here in NR status? How system is? So I'll tell you guys, with lightning speed it works. Isn't it? The moment you save it, have you seen like how much time it is taken for generating the document number, right? With the lightning speed it got generated. It means whatever the processing happened in background, it happened with a lightning speed. This much fast SAP is, right? So now this is what the logic. So what is the logic, and what is the logic behind this external number range? If you're going to apply a check mark here, then you need to give the document number manually. System is not going to determine the document number automatically. So this is what the logic behind document number, this is what the logic, guys. This is how system is going to generate a document number. This is how system is going to generate a document number. Okay. So now, so FB50 is going to be used as an alternative of F-02, and I'll tell you guys, better to use FB50 itself. Why? Because what is the benefit here in FB50? You need not remember debit and credit. Look at here, this document got posted. But if you see the doc transaction posting, guys, it is here you have selected debit and credit. But if you see the document, if you see the transaction, it will show you 40 and 50 itself. Click on document and click on display. If you click on display, look at here. FB03 is the transaction code. Even you can use FB03 also directly. So look at here, display, right? So display means here what is happening guys, 40 and 50 itself is appearing. No debit and credit, it is 40 and 50 it is appearing. But there in MP50 we are having selection in under selection vertical criteria, you can select in the terms of debit and credit instead of 40 and 50. That is a bit confusing, right? Because in upcoming session, multiple other posting key also will come into picture. So how come it possible to remember all this posting key? So no need to remember, guys. You are having options to select in the form of debit and credit. Why need to remember this posting key? But yes, you need to understand the control which is going to be made by posting key. That will be also. So practically, it is going to be explained, guys, one by one, one by one. So now here, with the help of this MP50, this is how you can post the transactions and how system is going to trigger the number ranges and all. Simply you have to say that first of all, system is going to trigger document type because the transactions are getting posted against document type. From document type, system is going to trigger the number range code which is assigned in the document type, and against that number range code, whatever range we have given against your company code is going to be triggered by system, and from that range system is going to generate a particular number. But again, the question is how system is going to generate the particular number in sequence wise only. So you have to say that for that NR status, number in status field is responsible, because whichever number got generated, latest number is going to be updated in NR status field. So always the next, when the next transaction is going to be posted, system will check the number in status, and in that automatically system is going to add one, and the next document number is going to be generated. This is what the logic behind this. So that's all in this session, guys. In next session, what I'll do, so in next session we'll check the field status, this field controls, okay, and then we'll see the GL reports. So field control, how the fields are getting controlled in the transaction post, during transaction posting, that I'll show you in next session.